In February 2020, 20 innovators across the U.S. started their journey through a competition aimed at energizing the American solar industry, the Solar Prize Round 3.
The Solar Prize is a three-stage prize competition, really expanding and accelerating solar innovations and building solar businesses and bringing manufacturing back to the United States.
Just 9 months later, two solar startups were selected as winners.
Team Maxout Renewables from Livermore, California. This team developed an appliance powered by a flywheel called the Evergrid that can turn residential solar installation into a microgrid to keep flowing during a power, during a grid outage, as long as the sun is shining. Or the second winner is Team Wattch from Atlanta, Georgia. This team created a solar monitoring platform that can help increase operational efficiency for commercial and industrial PV plants.
The two teams were selected for substantially advancing their solutions, taking them from proofs of concept to refined prototypes, and finding partners to perform pilot testing. But how did they get to where they are now? Both Maxout and Wattch submitted their innovations to the Solar Prize Round 3 in December 2019. In February 2020, they were selected as semi-finalists, earning $50,000 each. Next up, transforming their ideas into proofs of concept.
Funding for us at the stage of it in our lives and at the stage that our company was back in February, when we won the first check, I mean, that was a complete godsend for us. We could afford to buy the right test equipment that we needed for the hardware and pay to have prototypes made, things like that.
With COVID-19 shutting down labs and facilities across the country, these teams had to get creative with their resources. Things didn't always go as planned.
3D printed a coupling mechanism for this. And when I started to spin it up, it flew apart. It exploded at about 3000 RPMs. So I thought, okay, that's it. We can't do this, which, you know, but you dust yourself off and you realize, okay, well, that was stupid. Let's do some stress analysis and get real about this.
In July, the 20 semi-finalist teams pitched their ideas to industry experts in a virtual setting. In the end, 10 teams were announced as finalists, each winning $100,000 in cash prizes and $75,000 in technical support vouchers. As these teams entered the third and final phase of competition, they continued making progress in the midst of shutdowns.
I think despite having to do most of this work virtually, our round three teams and the progress that they made and the partnerships they formed were probably the strongest that we've seen collectively over the three rounds of the Solar Prize.
The additional funding and support vouchers allowed these innovators to connect with national labs and testing facilities they might not normally have access to.
Not only the basic funding, but the vouchers helped a lot as well. Like we've been able to do reliability testing with Sandia, and that's going to give us a lot of confidence to send these out to our customers and make sure that it's reliable for a long period of time. We never would have gone that far without having those vouchers to be able to use.
In December, the round three finalists again competed virtually, this time in the hopes of being one of two teams to take home $500,000.
We really felt like if we didn't win this, it wasn't because we didn't try. It was because something else that was so great that it beat the concept, it beat the work that we did.
Finally, the two winners of round three were announced, Maxout Renewables and Wattch Inc.
We worked really hard through this whole competition, and it was an honor to win. We're thrilled. It's still sinking in, to be honest.
Both teams received $500,000 in cash prizes and $75,000 in support vouchers, which they plan to use to hire teammates and get their innovations to market.
Now we have the ability to kind of finish the projects, make the purchases, do the things that we knew that we need to do kind of contingent on winning or contingent on investment. Now we can do all of them, which is just fantastic.
I guess it just really gives me the confidence that we will be able to give this absolutely everything we have, and that funding, credibility, none of that will be the reason that we don't hit all of our goals if we don't want to. It removes a lot of the unknowns.
With the help of the Solar Prize, these innovators have pushed their technologies closer to market.
A year ago, we had our idea, but we had no product, no patents. And now we have 3 patents filed and, a prototype that, is a real product.
Without this prize, we definitely, either it would have been a couple of years or so before we got to that point, or maybe we would have had to go down a different route, hire someone with that expertise, which is
hard.
But being able to do that early on in the company has really helped drive a lot of decisions. And I think that's been super invaluable and just a super unique part of the prize.
Fun too.
Yeah, super fun.
Congratulations, Maxout Renewables and Wattch.
We're excited to have you as a part of the Solar Prize family.